Sana marinig ang tinig mo, umasa na rin na sana'y mahawakan ko ang palad mo. Gusto ko sana lumapit, kundi lang sa lalaking kayakap mo. Sakit isipin, ito'y isang panaginip, panaginip lang. Dalhin mo ako sa iyong palasyo, maglakad tayo sa hardin ng iyong
hello, good morning everyone, especially to the our friends there in the Philippines. Isang mabagyong umaga sa inyong lahat. I know it's a little stormy out there in that part of the world, but I would like to greet our friends there in the Philippines. And of course, our friends here in Canada, it's a very warm evening here in Canada, this side of the world. But of course, we'd like to ask our friends to be safe there, aside from the virus. Please be safe also from the typhoon that is coming your way, Typhoon Ampo. So anyway, just for for you who are out there just inside the rooms, we have our new session for today. This is our session 5. So we already have 5 workshops, painting workshops, and I'm glad that you are joining me in this free workshops, painting, acrylic paintings. And this is open to everybody, including those who are first time who held their brush and their paints. Okay, so I hope we don't have any problems with the audio. I'm just going to check our notifications and we'll be right back. Few reminders. Okay, so far it has been good. No comments, no notifications, no violent reactions whatsoever. So anyway, welcome to our 5th painting session for today. And today is a special one. Because we're going to challenge you a little. Actually, it has been very challenging to me as well, because it is not that easy to paint this subject, but I had to practice twice to do this painting. One is the 3 panels, the triptych, and the other one is with a single panel. So just to see how I could do it in 1 hour. So I will be able to teach you this new masterpiece for you, hopefully by 1 hour and 15 minutes. There has been a lot of requests. Bagalat ko daw, slow it down. Okay, I will try my best to slow it down for you, kasi slow na po yun yung workshops ko sa inyo noon, but I will try my best to slow it down and let you paint. Okay? At makasabay kayo sa akin. That's why we call it Paint With Me, Jojin Ray. Okay? Alright. Okay. This is our subject. Ta-da! Okay? This is the seascape. The waves. And the sun. And the birds. Walang pating. Sorry, walang pating. Pwede nyo lagyan ng pating pag natapos nyo na yung seascape natin. Okay? So, we can all do this. You just have to follow me. Our technique here is to follow every step that I make. Okay? Every move that I make. Parang kanta, di ba? So, when I make a line, I let you draw the line. When I make a circle, I let you make the circle. So it's a step-by-step process. And believe me, a lot of people, even the first-timers, were able to finish their paintings with that kind of system where everybody just follows me. And it gives you an idea how the paint runs, how the brushes run, how you could put paint and mixed water and paints. Okay? So, just believe in yourself. We're going to do this. Tama-tama, di ba? Mabagyo. Pati yung dagat, mabagyo. Okay? Alright. Okay. So, the first thing that we're gonna do is, I hope you have one of your masking tape. Okay? I'm just going to use the green tape so that you could see the line. Actually, this is what we use for, this is a painter's tape, which we use for painting the walls, so we cover the sides, so it doesn't bleed out. So I'm going to use this just for the sake of demonstration. You could see the lines, okay? So, what we're gonna do, within. Okay. Okay, what we're going to do, okay, by the way, you have to set up your canvas, the landscape, okay, orientation, or what we call the horizontal, okay? This is the horizon. This is the vertical, or the portrait. And this is the landscape orientation. Okay, so try to find the middle one, okay? This is your middle, but you have to put a little bit higher. Okay? Okay, so you'll notice this is a little bigger and this is a little smaller. Alright? So that should be your area. Okay? And this is where you put your tape. Okay, so make sure it's sticking very well. Yeah. Okay, so you're done with the first part, but my easel is dancing. Okay, that should be fine. All right. Okay, so this part is our sky, and this is going to be our sea. Okay, this is the sea part. Now remember. Some of you might already you have done the sky with the sunset and the moon sky, okay? That is how we're going to do with this part already, okay? So we're just going to worry about this part first, okay? Don't mind this one. Concentrate on this area first, okay? Just relax. This is supposed to be a relaxing activity, okay? Focus on this part, later on with this part, okay? All right. Okay, so we have our brushes, big and small, okay? If you have a bigger one, okay, much better, but if you have the just the simple brush, a big one, that's okay, okay? And of course, you should have your paper towel or your tissue paper. You should have lots of it. Okay, to wash off your brush. All right, okay. So what you need, okay, the colors that you need for this part, okay, remember, do not worry about the bottom area. Let's focus on the upper area. Okay, what you need first, okay, let us start with white, okay, white, and then yellow. Then red, and blue. Okay, so just with the basic colors, you will be amazed how a lot of colors will be transformed in this combination of colors. Okay, when you mix it, okay, you will be surprised how it mingles together, blend together, and you will see a lot of colors. I'm still using the same blue. Okay, and a little black. Ubusan pa yata ako ng black. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, just prepare your colors first. Oh, yan, binabagalan ko na. I'll be right back. I'm back. Okay. So I got more white and blue. And there's our black. Okay. All right. So again, we have yellow, white, red, blue, and black. And of course, water. Okay. For the first timers, okay, please get your water and mix it on your plate, not on the canvas. Mix it on the plate before you put it there. Okay? All right. Okay, are we ready? Okay. From the center, you put white. Okay? Hindi nyo makita kasi white nga eh. Okay? And then next, okay, let's put a lot of yellow. Okay, just match your white there. Okay? Do not be afraid to put your colors there. Okay, do not be afraid to have pains on your hands, your fingers. Okay. Okay, so there's our yellow. Okay. Take lots of, load it. We call it load. Load it with paint. Splatter beside the white. Okay. So take note, I'm not yet brushing it. I'm just putting it there. Yan. Okay. Oh. Okay. So, pwede pa maglagay habang nagtitiktok kayo, di ba? Ganyan. Ayan. Pwede pa nakapikit. Yan. Okay. Next. The red. Splat. 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 Oh, di ba? Saya, di ba? Ganyan lang. Okay. So, habang nagkakalat kayo ng paints dyan, okay, we'd like you to request that after this painting, please post it on your Facebook. Be proud of your artwork. And then, make a short message to offer your paintings thinking of our galan frontliners, okay, para sa mga frontliners natin ito sa Baguio City, sa Cordillera, sa buong mundo. Okay, yan, lapit na matapos. Alright, next color is the blue. Okay, so again, same as what you did with the red and yellow. Splatter all around there. Okay, so the outside is more darker. So there's more color blue. Yan, mas marami siya. Kaya mo yan, kahit tumulo. Okay, so pasensya na, please pardon me if I squint a lot. Nagaganyan ako kasi I can't see. I cannot see what's in front of me. I have to use my eyeglasses, but I don't like to wear my eyeglasses when teaching. Okay, so there. Yan. Diba? Ang saya. Saya ng painting. Okay, and last color is your black. Okay, try to mix it also on the sides. So I also had to do a lot of experiments how to make it easy for you to do this painting. Okay, some of you who have tried painting already, they won't do this. Okay, there's another technique, but this one is the easiest for you and the easiest way to do this painting, and also the easiest way for me to be teaching you this one. Okay, so you all have those colors there. Okay, now you're ready to blend. This is the fun part. Okay, dapat dito mabilis eh, but I have to slow it for you. Okay, now your biggest brush, you have to wash it very well. Okay, and you have to wipe it very well that it is so clean, should be dry, and then you start in the middle. Okay, so this is what we call the brightest part of your sky. Okay, so wipe it from the middle. Okay, so you see it's starting to merge, starting to blend. Okay, make sure that you leave this part very white. Okay, because that is where the sun is. Okay, wipe it down. Okay, very very dry. Your brush should be very dry. And then try to mix them up. Okay, before they dry up. Okay. Oh, yung buwi, bilis na naman ako. Slow motion. Yan, ganyan. Slow motion. See? I'm letting the other colors blend with each other. Yeah, diba? Okay. So you see this part is very, very bright. Okay, wipe it again. Make sure that it's clean so that it doesn't ruin your bright colors here. Okay. So there's a little red there and blue, and then it's starting to show some violet over there. Now, if you also have a bigger brush, okay, it's easier to blend. Just let it dry a little. Okay, I ask you to have a blower beside you, okay? Just a little bit, okay, and then you have to, even with your smaller brush, just make sure that they're dry, and then try to mix them up. Okay, you have to rub it. Okay, just let it mix without covering the lighter part there. Okay, you can stroke it like this, or you can make circular motions. Okay, there. Okay, using the smaller brush, you could also use the bigger one. Okay, whatever comes out of the colors that you placed there, that is going to be your sky. Okay, okay, so I'm blending the other colors. Okay, just wash. It's like it's for the girls. When you do your blush on this, that's how you do it also with your painting. Okay, never mind if there's red there, if there's blue there, that's okay. Because every day when you watch a sunset, there's no the same sunset. There's always a different sunset every day, even in the other parts of the world. That's why it's so beautiful to look at the sunsets. Okay, just rub it down. Now, if you think that you would like to make it brighter, okay, just make sure it's a little dry. Okay, you can add more colors. Okay, if you like to add more yellow, just put here. Okay, and let it mix. Okay, make sure that you still have that white part there. So just get your white and put in the middle so it remains very bright in the middle. Okay. Spread it and rub again if you like. Okay, again, while we're doing this, actually I also encourage you to try your creativity when doing this. Okay, so that doesn't mean when I do this, you don't have to add clouds or anything. Just do what you want, okay? So when we say with clouds, you can also rub it with formations of clouds there. Okay, white. So you should have at least some cloud formations there, okay? Yeah. You can also put some violet. Okay, so what's our violet again? Okay, blue and then red. That's our violet. Okay, blue and red. If you want to make it lighter, just add a little bit of white. Okay, so you have your violet. Okay. Okay, so you have your clouds there. Whatever comes out of it is okay. Okay, just let it blend with the other colors. All right, just a tip when you're doing this kind of sunset. Okay, whenever you have a cloud there, okay, remember the highlights. Remember the source of lights. Okay, this is our source of light. Okay, so this part of the cloud, okay, is being hit by the sun rays. So meaning, this side of the cloud should be a little bit brighter. Okay, so just put a little bit of white underneath. Just underneath and let it blend. Okay, same here. Okay, again, you don't have to do the clouds. It's just another addition to your sky, just to make it more dramatic. Okay, yeah. Oops. Okay, let it merge, let it blend. Get some red, play with the red, and you have orange. Okay, so just remember that there are no rules. Okay? Walang bawal sa arts. Pag sinabing bawal, wala palang bawal sa arts. Okay? So, mag-comply lang kayo para pag natapos yung painting, ay pwede ka na palang mag-paint. Oh, di ba? Galing ni Kim Chu. Hello, Kim Chu. Sikat ka na. Okay. And some red. Okay, so you can play with a lot of colors. Make your sky very, very colorful. Okay. And what can I say? Romantic. What else? Everything's there. Okay. Yan. So that's our sky there. So I don't know if what stage are you in now with your sky. Okay, so do not be conscious of your colors there. Just play with it. Okay, because after this, if you don't like it, just put white again, yellow, merge again. Okay? Like I said, walang bawal. Just fixing my clouds there while you're doing your sky, because like you said, magalan ko, slow down and give you time to catch up with your colors. Yeah. Okay na kaya? Are you okay? Okay, we'd also like to greet our friends in Kalinga and Apayao. Some families there are watching and also doing their paintings. Ayan. Oh, tapos na ako. Okay, so anyway, like we said before, if you're done with this one, let it dry and we could go on to the next part. Okay? So I'll give you 30 seconds to fix your sky. Okay, sorry about the humming sound. That is the furnace, our furnace. Okay, so we move on to the next part of our painting, and that is going to be waves. Okay, yeah, getting more exciting. Okay, so we take off our tape. Yeah. So talaga magtanggal ng tape ng painting ganito. Okay, slowly. That's the best feeling. Taking it off. And so that's how you do your horizon. Straight na straight, no, di ba? Okay. Now, the next part, okay, is a little delicate here, so we have to make our outline, okay? Alright, okay. So, using our brush, okay, like you said, we don't use pencils here, we use our brush, okay? Let's use our light blue, just for sketching, okay? So, just your blue, and just a little bit of white, and you have a light blue. Okay, so I'm going to do the outlines, and give you time to follow it, okay? So, this is going to be our outline. Okay, from here, from this part here, and then going down. Yeah. Okay, straight line. Okay, and then from there, we have to make a slope. Okay, think of the mountains of Baguio, slope, and then up. Okay, what? And then another line here. This curve here, make another curve there. Okay, so that's your curves. Okay, one line, then curve going down, another curve going up, and another line here. Okay, so this one actually is the wave. Okay, so everybody has seen the waves by the beach as in Dalapasigan, the beach na that beach. Oh, okay, going down. Okay, the waves is going down, and this is the edge of the beach. Okay. Go on, eh? Okay. Now, if you're done with your outline, okay, just let it be there. Okay. Don't worry, we can cover it later on. Okay. All right. This part is the farthest part of the sea. Okay. To show you the sample again. This is the sea. Okay, the farthest part of the sea there. Okay? Yeah. Okay. So this part here, we should be coloring it with dark blue. Or your navy blue or your royal blue, whatever blue that you have. If you have a light blue or sky blue, just put a little bit of little bit of black, okay, or a little bit of red, just to make it darker. Okay, so we're going to paint this with blue. Okay, just this part. Okay, remember that this is our outline. Okay, so I'm covering this with okay, para hindi kayo mahirapan. Okay, you can put back the tape again there, so you don't have any problems doing the horizon there. Okay, so I'm just covering this with blue. Okay, so we're doing this step by step now. The upper part should be color blue. Yeah. Okay. So that's our farthest part of the BC. So, by the way, those who can't paint now but are still watching, remember that you could still do this by just going back to my wall and just rewind it and play it all over again. Okay, so starting next week, we will be doing it live also on YouTube, and the other videos being placed on YouTube as well. So for the others who could not go on live with me. Okay, so I'm making another shade for the blue. Remember to mix a little water just to make it easy for you to spread it. Okay, remember, just like what we did with the clouds there, okay, to make it brighter on this part, okay, just try to put some white there. And let it blend with the blue. Okay. Just a little bit, okay? Just a little bit. Okay? Okay, and then cover the others with blue. Okay, so I hope you're following. Okay, so we're doing this painting workshop for everyone to learn how to paint and also something to do during this COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, you learn something and then at the same time you are safe in the confines of your house. Okay. Alright. Okay, so there you have the sky. Let it dry and we go to the other parts of the seascape. Okay, so this part is now what we call the wave. Okay, wave. Yeah. Okay, remember when we did the waterfalls? That's why I taught you how to paint the waterfalls. You're now going to be able to use that technique here in our wave. Okay. So this part, okay, this part here, we are going to cover it with dark blue, okay, your blue, mix it with black, mix it with blue, okay, so it's going to be a little dirty, okay, don't worry about that, okay. So you cover this one, okay, almost black, almost gray. Okay, as soon as you go up there, okay, take a lighter one or a white, okay, and let it blend going up, okay. So it's still gray, but it's a little lighter than the color down here. Okay, remember the waterfalls that you did last week? Okay, so there. Okay, so you have your lighter part there. As you go down, that is a darker part. Okay? So you still have your outline there. Alright? We're almost halfway with our seascape. And I hope I'm a little slow for you now. I'm trying my best to be very, very slow. There was one comment by a daughter, and she said to her mother, he talks fast and he paints fast. Nagsasabay pala yung pagsalita ko sa kapag paint ko. Yeah, okay. Now let's go to this part. Okay? Just this part. Okay? Now, remember the what we did with the moon? Okay, three layers. Okay? So this part here, we are going to use the dark blue. Okay? So we'll have it. Okay? Just this one, we cover it with blue. Okay? Okay, don't worry. Whatever comes out of your painting, that is okay. Okay? There is nothing perfect, nothing exact. It's still a work of art. Okay? Okay, so there's your blue. Okay? And the next part would be a little lighter. Okay? So get your blue. Okay, if you have your blue there, just add a little bit of white and you have a lighter blue that you can use. Okay, so a lighter blue just up here. Too light. Okay, just a lighter blue there. Okay, and let it blend with the dark color down there. Okay, so it's, when you notice it's dark to light already. Okay, and then as you go up, okay, as you go up there, the more lighter that you go. Okay. it blend. Don't mind the lines there. They are so raw. That's okay. And then when you go up there, just use your white. And that part should be a little lighter than the other colors. Okay. Now there you have it. Okay, so dark blue, your blue, a little black, and then some blue with a little white, and then as you go up, more blue and a little blue as you go up. Okay. Okay, now you'll notice that this part is already dry. So like I mentioned before, work on the other areas, let the other area dry, and then when this is dry, go back to the other area to do the other painting jobs. Okay, so probably with your smaller brush. Okay, you can start making white lines here. Okay, not too solid, just very light. So it shows like a reflection of this area here. Okay. So from some areas, there might be some waves. Okay, so you have to put a little bit of those white there and some white there. So they will look like water with a lot of waves. Okay. Okay, so there's your reflection and the other waves there. And okay, so by the time you finish this one is okay already. Okay, alright. So the next one, okay, is to work on this part here. Okay, to cover this one. Okay, alright. Okay, this one is just a mixture of different shades of blue. Okay, so it is not solid blue. It's just a mixture of light blue, dark blue, even a little black, even a little bit of white. Okay, however, when you do it, there should be a direction of your brush. Okay, what I mean is okay. I'll just show you. I'll just show you, just for demo purposes, when you do your covering here, okay, you have to do it in a wavy direction, okay? So when we say wavy, okay, it's like this, okay? Okay, just for demo purposes, so you could see it, okay? Take it closer. Okay, so cover it while making the wavy action of the brushes are wave. Okay, so wave, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. because it's going to be like there's a typhoon or the winds are so strong. Okay, so remember, this is the part. The winds are not so strong in this part of the sea already. Okay, so just wave it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and then get some blue, other shade. Get some black. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Just like that. Okay, until this part is covered. Okay. Okay, so let's cover this one now. Okay, so observe, when I cover this, okay, I'm just covering it with little waves, okay? One, two, up, down, okay? So never mind if there are some white spaces there, just leave the white spaces there. Okay, so up and down, down, up, down, and up. Okay. Okay, again. Okay, up, down, okay, until they're covered. Okay, so do not just use one color, try to get another color like white, and then go over it, so there's some kind of texture that comes out. Okay, so up, down, up. Now, okay. Okay, so you see how it's blending with the other colors there, okay? Okay, so go back again with another kind of blue. Let it blend with the other colors. Okay, go up and down, go up and down. Okay, so it's not just a straight line, the same way that we did with this one and this one. Okay, this one, we're just doing it with a lot of wave. Okay, wave, up, down. And then let it merge, okay? Using the same strokes. Okay, so by doing this, you're already covering a lot of areas in your canvas, and at the same time, it's showing some texture of the waves. Okay, they would look like waves. So up, down, up, down. Get another color. And let it blend. blend with the rest of the colors until such time that there is no more white showing off. Okay, so little by little, you are able to cover those white spaces there, at the same time making it look like some waves there. Okay, so on this side, try to add more white because this is our source of light, so there's a lot of white on this side of the waves there. Okay, so those are just water there. Okay, do not worry a lot about those waves there. I'm also adding another color there, the black, okay, aside from the blue. Okay, and just let it blend. Okay, so it still doesn't make sense in the first half of our lower part, but later on we are going to do the other parts, and it's going to look like some waves already. Okay, so I'll give you time to do your waves here. Okay, up and down, up and down. Okay. Okay, so just take your time. Alright, so I think this is already dried here. Okay, so this part is now our next coloring area. Okay, so let this dry, let this dry, let this dry. Okay, we do this part now. Okay, so this part is just another shade of the gray. Okay. So just another shade of like dirty blue or gray, and just cover this part. Okay, just cover this with dark blue or a little gray. Just make it a little shade of gray or dark gray on this part. Okay. So at first glance, it doesn't show any sense. Okay, where's the wave or where's the rock? Okay, but we'll go there. We're doing it one step at a time. Okay, and you will be surprised how we're going to do this. You're going to do this. Okay. Okay, so let's try this up. So make sure everything is very dry before you do the finishing touches on the wave. Okay, because when it's wet, okay, no matter how you put paint on it, it will never make sense, or it will not happen that there's going to be another color on it. It has to be very, very dry before you put another paint. Okay, alright, okay. So this part, we're now ready. This one, we're now ready. Okay, alright. So we're going to do this part now. Okay, this one is the crest of the wave, the part of the wave that's going down. Okay, so how do we do that? Okay, remember when we did the waterfalls? Okay, just get your white, okay, and a little blue, okay, almost that way. Not so wet, okay? Your brush must not be very, very wet. It's a little dry, okay? Just a little bit, okay? Remember the waterfalls? We start from the top, okay, here. Okay, let's put a white line here. Okay? Now, from the top, okay, make a curving motion or the falling motion, okay, and going down, okay. It should be flowing, okay, not straight, okay, it's curved there, okay. See the white lines there, okay. Make sure that this area is not colored white or solid white, okay? It has to have some wave looking lines there, okay? So just the tip of your brush, start from the top and then slide down, okay? Go down, go down, go down. Okay, you can do it again. Okay, put the white there and then go down. Okay, so it's starting to look like the top of the wave there. Okay. If you have a bigger brush, okay, just the tip of the brush there, and then start from the top and then slide down, okay, go down, go down, go down, okay. So it's showing that it's flowing, okay, over the top of the from the top of the wave, and it flows down and it crashes on this part. All right okay, so this part should be a little bit brighter. Why? Because like I said, this is the source of light and this should be a little bit brighter. Okay, and slide it down. Okay, so I can see from my monitor there, it's a little delayed, like 5 seconds or 10 seconds. Okay, so it looks like a wave now. Okay, So I hope you were able to do this part now. Now the next part, okay, is the splash of the wave, okay, the splashing. Now this is where you can use the technique with the trees. Okay, remember what you did with the trees? It's called dabbing. You dab the tip of your brush, okay, on the canvas. Okay, now to be able to use that, okay, you have to wash your brush very well. Okay, make sure that it's very, very dry and clean, because you're only going to use solid white. Okay, solid white. Okay, from here, okay, you have to start from here, this part, then going there. Okay, so all you have to do is make some dots. Okay, so they look like the tip of the waves there. Okay, tiny ones. Okay, that is with the brush. Okay, if you have a bigger brush, the better. Okay, like the one inch brush. Okay, just use the tip of your brush to splatter those white ones over the top of the waves. Okay, so I'll just do it very slowly. Okay. And just splatter over the blue line there. Okay. Never mind if it goes to the sea there. Okay. It has better effect. Just cover the blue line with a lot of splattering white. Okay. Okay. There you go. And it looks like the splatters of the wave already. Okay. Okay, just spread it out. Okay. Now this part, there is more splatters than this one, because this one already touched or crushed on the beach line. Okay. Okay, just fill it up with white. Okay, make sure that no blue line shows there. Okay, remember that we had the blue line there earlier. Okay. You can also use this with your bigger brush. Okay, just very dry brush and solid white. Okay, no mixing of water. Okay. Okay, splatter on the blue area there and here. Make sure that you do not cover this part, so this flowing motion still shows on your canvas. Okay. There. Okay. So they look like waves now. Just cover it with a lot of white. Okay. Yes. Okay. Now as we go here, this is going to be the biggest splash. Okay. This is going to be the biggest splash. So you just have to cover this with a lot of white. Okay. By using the tip of your brush. Okay. Not too much of white. Just the tip of your brush. Be patient. Okay. Because if you get a lot of paint there and you put it there, it's going to come out solid white. Okay. Just a little bit. Okay. and you have to splatter all over this area. Okay, make sure that it reaches the outside. I'm sure you will, you already witnessed how the waves crash on the beachhead or on the rocks. Okay, just let it splatter there. Okay, for you to be able to see it, okay, I'm just splattering a lot of white over the glue there. Okay, leave some glue there. Okay, do not cover it with solid white. Okay, just leave some space there with blue and white, so there's a texture on your crushing waves. Okay, yeah, okay, so you already have your crushing waves. Okay, dali, di ba? Okay, so just fill up your waves with a lot of white. Okay, do not be afraid to go out of the area there. You can spread it like exploding the water towards the sky. That's why we made this very dark but colorful, so we should be able to do a lot of splashing. Okay, there. Oh, galing, di ba? I'm sure you were able to do that just by dabbing the tip of your brush on your painting. Okay, so pag nagtitiktok kayo, ganun lang. Okay? Ayan. Yoo-hoo! Alright. Okay, dagdagan natin dito para nakikita pa yung I think my blue line is still showing there. Alright. Okay. So, I'm just excited to see your outputs later on. By the way, okay, they told me to talk more so that you will have more time to paint. Okay, so by the way, after this, we always have the practice of posting our pictures, our paintings. Don't forget to offer it to our dear frontliners and then post your paintings with you. Now this time, kasi last week we did our sexy post and funny post with our paintings. This time we're going to do okay, my team, I have a team. Okay, we decided to offer this to our frontliners. So with our paintings, we're going to do the pose with our mask. Okay, and then hold your painting. Okay, with mask. Kung meron kayong face shield, okay lang. Does it have to be an N95? Surgical, homemade, okay lang yun. Wag lang yung napkin. Kadiri naman yun pag napkin ang ginamit nyo pang pose. Okay, so nakamask and then your painting. Okay? Kasi pag wala yung mask, nakaka-distract. Dahil mas nakikita yung mukha nyo kaysa painting. Dapat takpan muna para walang distraction. Painting muna tayo. Okay? Yan. Alright, so while we're having this dried up, okay, anyway, this is being recorded, and this is going to be replayed, Okay, you can always come back to my wall and watch it again and do your painting. Okay? Okay, this one is to be dried up. We go to this part. Okay, now this part, this is the one that's going up. Okay, so this one we have to do some lines here to make it look like it's going up and crushing. Okay, so what we're gonna do, okay, we're going to use a shade of blue, just a little bit of shade of blue, okay, and we start from here, okay, and it's supposed to be going up, okay, so the motion would be going up like this, okay. So that is the direction, okay, so it's like this, okay. When we do that, it has to be a little shaky, okay. Those are some, I don't know what they call this, this part where there are lines there, okay, just make a lot of lines just like the branches of the tree, so you are able to use the other techniques, okay, in other kinds of paintings, okay. There, just like lightnings, okay. So that part, okay, just to make it more wave looking, okay. Yeah. Now, under the waves, okay, after you're finished with these white lines here, under the waves, try to put some darker shade under the waves here. So it shows like some shadow under the waves there. There, just dab it a little so it shows like some shadow under the wave. Okay? Okay, so I hope your crushing waves there is already okay for you. If not, okay, you can always go back, do it again. Okay, that is what's nice about acrylic, because you can continue covering it with another color. You don't like it, cover it with white again and paint another one. Okay? Nang oras na. All right, so we can go to the next step. Okay. The other blue here. Okay, remember we had the other blue here. Okay, now this time, just what we did with the white ones here, try to put another white here on the blue line that we made earlier. Okay, so you're just going to put or just dab white on it. So the blue line doesn't show, okay, So they would look like waves still. Okay, no line showing there. Okay, just cover it so the blue line doesn't show. Never mind here. We're gonna cover that anyway later on. Alright, okay, next one. Okay, we're going to do the rocks. Okay, so if you'll notice, we just splattered all over this part, okay, without knowing where the rock is, okay, because we can just paint the rock over it, okay. As you well know, the rock is, the waves is behind the rock, so the rock should be in front, so we can cover the waves with the rock here. Okay, now if you have a brown there, okay, you have a personal brown color there, that's good. Okay, just put a little black. If you don't have, all you have to do is mix blue and yellow for the brown. Okay, that's so light. Blue and red and a little bit of yellow. Okay, again, blue, red and yellow. You have a brown. If you have a dark one, that's just perfect. Okay, we need a dark brown first. Okay, so we'll put a little bit of black. Okay, now with your dark brown there, okay, you have to form your stone or your rocks. Okay, so I'll make an outline first. You can form your own rock if you like. Okay, there's your rock, and another one at the back. There, okay, and just color them solid black or solid brown, dark brown. Okay, so now your waves is behind the rock. Okay, just solid dark brown first. Okay, and I'll show you how to make the highlights of the rocks so it would look like rocks. Okay, so you're almost done already. You can also add some more rocks if you like. Okay, smaller ones. Smaller ones. Okay. There you go. Just shape your rocks any way you want it. So you now have the waves, and then in front is your rocks. You Kaya pala wala sinasabi pag nag-aantay. Hirap talaga ng nag-aantay. No? Okay, I hope you have your shape of your rock there. That's very tough. So I can teach you how to make the highlights of the rock. Yeah. Okay, so this part is already dry. This is your rock. Okay, actually this is our last part already of our seascape painting. Okay? Alright. So we could probably use the a smaller brush. Okay? Smaller than the biggest brush that we were using a while ago. And we are going to use a lighter shade of the brown that we used a while ago. Okay. The principle of the highlights is that one part of the rock is lighter. The other side is a little darker. So for demonstration, okay, I'll just enlarge it, okay, just for you to understand it. Okay, so a while ago, okay, we had our rock. Okay, this is our rock, for example. Okay, we painted it as a solid a while ago. Dagdag kaalaman na ito, dagdag kaalaman. Okay, abang libre. Take advantage. Okay, alright, so those are our solid objects. Okay. So when we say highlights, okay, when you're doing your seascape there. When we say highlight, one part, okay, is always the lighter part. Okay, this is our source of light. Okay, this is our source of light. Okay, so whenever we face the sun, this is always the lighter part. Okay, so this one should be lighter. Okay, so if you notice, this part of the ball or the sphere is lighter on this part, and this is the dark. So this is what we call the high light. This one is the low light. Low light because there's very low light. Pwede na ang low light. Okay? Very dark. Just like the moon. That's why we only see this. Okay? And this will be the high light. Okay, so actually this is also what I wanted to teach for you to be able to appreciate the principle of the shades and the shadows. Okay? How you can do that with your trees, your houses, your rocks. Okay, just like this one. Okay, so if we have our sun here, okay, this side of the rock should be brighter. Okay. Okay, for example, okay, that is your rock. Okay, so when you look at the rock, this one is a little lighter. Okay, because this is the only part that is being hit by the sun. Okay, so when we go to our painting here, this one should be a little lighter. Okay, so to make it to have more texture in it, just I'm using the big brush. Okay, just color it with light brown. Okay, and when you do it, do not paint it solid. Okay, still wet. Okay, just dab on it so it would look like very rough on your rocks. Okay. Just this part of your rock. Okay. And another one here. Maybe another one here. So you have at least three rocks there. Okay, so they look like your trees now. Okay, okay, naglobat na yung mga laptop, mga tablets. It's okay. All right. Okay, so going back to our rocks here, they look like rocks now. Okay, let it dry. Oh wait, let's put some shade with the other rocks also. Okay, just the top of your rocks. Okay, just the top of it, because that's the only part that is taking the source of light from this area. Okay, just tap. So they would look like rocks. Okay, tap. There, okay. It's dry, put another shade on top of it so they would look more brighter. Okay, again, Okay, just dab on it. Okay, this is now lighter than the light brown that we placed there. Okay, so you'll notice I'm just dabbing it over the brown there. So they would look like rough rocks by the sea. Okay. So here too. There you go. Okay. They look like rocks. Alright. We're almost done. Okay. Now what would we do with this part here? Okay. All you have to do is splatter some white paint over here. Okay. So let's use the, I think not everyone has the 1-inch brush. Okay. So just take your brush, okay, and cover just below it with white. There. Okay. Splatter it so there's like a remember the bottom of the waterfalls that we made before? Just cover this one with white and a little bit here by the little rocks here. There, okay. Yeah. Okay. So if you're not contented with your sky, just cover it with white or yellow and then work over it again. However, you have to splatter again because you painted on this part. It's going to cover a lot of your white there. Just go back and splatter it again with white. It's also nice to have this kind of brush for painting. It can also help with your painting, especially big ones. Okay. Go. Okay, we're going to add some birds. However, I don't have to teach you the details of a seagull, but I could show you the shortcut of doing one. However, you have to use a very fine brush. Okay, so we have two small brushes here. Okay, you might want to choose a darker part of the painting here, like this part for the birds. Okay, now when you do the birds, okay, for demo purposes again, okay, I'll just show it in a bigger brush. Okay, and I'm just going to use the black. However, here we're going to use the white one. Okay. Okay. So, when making the bird, Okay, all you have to do is one, make small check. Okay. And one big check. One big long check. Okay. Kuha. One more. Okay, one small check. And then one big check. Okay. That's a bird. Okay. I'm just making it easy for you. Okay, one small check and one big check. Okay, now when you do the seagull, okay, okay, for example, this is the sky. I have to paint it on a dark one. Okay, one small check, one big check. Okay, small check, big check. Okay. So that they will look like seagulls. The tip of the wings there, you have to color it with black. Okay, just cover it with black, just the tip. End tip. And they would look like seagull from afar. Alright? Okay, so first we do the check mark. You can draw as many birds as you like. Okay, so again, okay, I'll do it here. Okay, one small check and one long check. Okay, one more, one check, one long check. Okay, and then take a finer brush, get your black, and cover the tip with block. That's how seagulls look from afar. Okay? Yeah. Just white and then black tip. Okay? You don't have to be exact with that because this is painting. This is art. You don't have to be exact because if we wanted to, we can take a camera, take a picture, and you have an exact photo of the seagull, but this is painting. You're using brushes, you're using your canvas and colors, and it is what it is. Wow. Okay, so may kulang pa. Okay, I had deviated from the original painting. Okay, especially for you, because I'm sure some of you has very dark sky because of the continuous blending of the colors until they lost the white and the yellow. So all you have to do is to get a smaller brush and you can paint your sun in the middle. Okay, so just make a small circle there. Okay, just for those who has a dark background already. Okay, so yan, you have your sun there. Dapat dito, pero just for purposes of teaching you that you can put the sun there, especially with dark background, just paint it over with white and you're done. Okay, you can add some more white here. Okay. Okay, you can improve your waves here if you like. Just do some with a fine brush. Okay. Like I told you, just make some wave motion like this, okay? Your birds there, they look like seagulls, not bats from Wuhan. They look like seagulls, okay, from Canada. And the waves crashing by the seashore on the rocks. Okay, gusto nyo maglagay ng pating, lagay lang kayo ng paliktik ng pating dun. Okay, greetings to Debbie. Ayan na yung pating. Lagyan mo na pating dito. Sa gitna. O, may pating cut. Okay? Alright. So, what else? Okay, so I think that's it for today. This is your seascape. Okay? Ayan. Hindi ko alam kung ano mas maganda dyan. Okay, so you have two different sunsets. And they differ. Okay? But the technique is the same. Okay? So all you have to do is to be creative with your sky, your sun. And then do the techniques. And you'll be fine. Okay? So I hope you were able to get your seascape for today. You can just go back to our wall and rewind the video all over again and then paint with me. Also paint with your children, your wife, your husband, your friends. Ay, wag muna friends kasi quarantine pa pala. Just stay at home and paint with your own family. Okay? So, hopefully next week we start a presentation on YouTube. Subscribe on my account, Jojin Ray. Yan po yung pangalan ko, yung channel ko sa YouTube. And then we will go live also from YouTube starting next week. If you are still interested, please continue watching and painting with me. So, I'd like to greet my sister, Bobet Tamayo, and Rayjan, and all of the Tamayo family in Baguio City. And of course, to all our friends there, stay home, be safe. Sa mga beshies ko, maraming salamat sa inyo. Salamat. Okay, see you next week. And mabuhay. Be safe, everyone. Don't forget to offer our paintings for our frontliners. And please post your pictures and paintings to inspire others to paint also. Okay? So, thank you very much and take care. God bless. Yeah.